Alrighty, today guys, in this video here, we are going to change out some lower control arms. So if you've ever wanted to see how to do lower control arms, this is the video for you. Guys, so the only thing that's going to be different with my application versus y'all's is you see I have pullovers in there. So you know y'all are going to have coil springs with a shock down the middle. So of course you're probably going to have to, if they're lifted springs, you're going to have to compress the springs with a spring compressor. If they're regular stock springs, sometimes you can put a jack right up under here and slowly let it down, and it'll release it enough to where you can pull them out. But in this application here, I got these coilovers, so I'm going to have to crank them down. And actually, we're going back to springs and the shocks down the middle. So that's the whole reason of changing these control arms. So that's what we're doing. Of course, on this video here, you got to take that cotter pin out, that nut, and that lower ball joint. You don't necessarily have to take this top one off to do these lower control arms, but I'm going to go ahead and do it here so I can get this whole thing kind of out of the way. Plus, I need to reroute this brake cable underneath. Also, you got to take your sway bar link bolt here out, and then you can start on the rest of your stuff. Man, guys, the struggle on these springs, because they were heavy duty and brand new, was for real. I like to never got them in. I couldn't compress them enough hardly to get them up in that, short enough. And then on top of that, I got one of those little hooks hung up when I finally got it in there. It was such a beat down. And I finally just quit recording after a while because I'm like, this is a catastrophe. Yep, I definitely don't like doing coil springs. Not these kinds on trucks. The car ones ain't so bad, but these heavy duty truck springs, you can freaking forget it. And then the way these are built up in that frame area, half of it goes up in there, so it's almost impossible to get your coil spring compressor back out once you get it all positioned and stuff up in there. Now, as you can see here, I finally got the one side together, so I'm lubing up all that new ball joint and all that. So, yep, that's about it. Footage wasn't all that great, apologize for that, but yeah, we started getting in a rush and we were frustrated, so you forget sometimes that the camera's even on. So here you're finally seeing the completed product. This is how I went with the brake lines and all that, what I was showing you, how I routed those with the ABS sensor wire. But that's the new lower control arm, the brakes, lift spindle, all that together now. New shocks, of course. That's how she looks. Nothing spectacular. Thanks for watching.